Good evening, Tuan Khoi. Here is the explanation of your problem. Let's begin. So you mentioned that this sum, all right, the sum of the number of dogs and chickens is equal to how many? 36. Okay. Oops, missing an N. There you go. That's 36. Now, you also mentioned that the sum of all the legs of the dogs and chickens, of the 36 dogs and chickens, is equal to 100. So I'm just going to put 100 here. Okay. And then, how are we going to do this? All right. So dogs have four legs. Let's just put that here. Four times the number of dogs plus 2 times the number of chickens. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. Since it's quite difficult to write everything, we must represent them with variables, or we call them letters. Okay, so A for dogs, and then we have B for chickens. In this way, it will be much easier for us to solve the problem. Now here we go. Let us substitute. Substitute is to replace. So let's take the first equation. So we've got two equations here. It's number one equation and number two equation. Equation. So equation means it's anything, actually. It can be a very long equation. It can be short, as long as it has the equal sign. That is called an equation. Like 5 plus 7 equals 12. 10 times 4 equals 40. That is an equation. So here we go. Let us substitute the variables to the equation. So A plus B, number of dogs plus the number of chickens, oops, is equal to 36. Next, 4 times dogs, 4 times A is 4A, all right, plus 2 times the number of chickens is 2B. Then let's copy the total number of legs, which is 100. Okay, so here we go. What we're going to do now is to simplify. That means to make your equations simpler. It's called simplify. Okay? All right. So how do we simplify this? So A plus B plus 36 is like 1A plus 1B equals 36. There is no GCF or greatest common factor. So we can only divide the whole equation by 1. So no need to do that. Now we have this. It's a little bit more complicated. We make this simpler by thinking of what would be the greatest number that we could divide to all of these 3, 4, A, 2, B, and 100. I think it's 2, because you can divide 2 by 2, but you cannot divide 2 by 4 and end up with a whole number. No. So the greatest common factor, or the biggest possible number we can divide the whole equation, is 2. So we divide this by 2. 4A divided by 2, that is 4 divided by 2 is 2. So that is 2A. Very simple. 2B divided by 2 is, copy the plus sign, and that's B. Then we have 100 divided by 2 is 50. So equation 1, Still the same. Equation 2 is now simplified to this. This is our second equation. So let me write the first and second equation here. A plus B is equal to 36. That's equation 1. Now we have equation 2. 2A plus B is equal to 50. Okay, so how are we going to solve this? It's really, really difficult if you look at it the first time, but you will understand throughout the process. Okay, the only way to solve is to find out the value of at least one variable. So the variables A and B. I think since in the second equation, let's see here, why don't we go ahead and leave B on this side? Say B. Now, in order to get rid of 2A, what are we going to do? We're going to minus 2A. And then minus 2A on the other side as well. Just to balance, you know, what you minus here on this side is what you minus on the other side. So that will still be equal. I'll explain to you. Example, 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. So let's say this is the equation. So if I minus 4 here, I should also minus 4 on the other side. Understood? So 5 plus 2 is 7 minus 4, that is 3. 7 minus 4 is also 3. So whatever you do on this side of the equation, on the left side, you should also do on the right side. So what are we going to do? All right, so you leave B here. Now, 2A minus 2A is 0. No need to put that here. It's already 0. Now, 50 minus 2A. That's what we are left with. Now we know the value of B in terms of variable A. We are using variable A here. Okay, now the fun part is you're going to substitute the value of B to the first equation. All right, so A plus, what is the value of B? It's 50 minus 2A. So let's put that here instead of B. So 50 minus 2A. Understood? And then we just copy 36. This is from the first equation, okay? Now, let's do this. What to do? Okay. So, A minus 2A is like 1 minus 2. So that we will be left with negative A. How about the 50? We deduct the 50 here. We deduct, the 50 on the other side of the equation, just to make it 0. Now we have 36 minus 50. So negative A is now equal to, what is 36 minus 50? That will be negative 14. To get rid of the negative of variable A, we multiply it to negative 1, the whole equation. Now it's going to be A is equal to 14. Now let's go back to the top. Now we have the value of A, which is 14. Put it up here. There. So A plus B equals 36. 14 plus B equals 36. Now let's leave letter B here and transpose. That is to deduct, to make it zero on this side. Understood? Okay, so that will be crossed out now. That will be zero. Now we're left with B. 36 minus 14 is 22. There you go. How to check? So A plus B, A is 14. There we have it. And B, 22 is equal to 36. How about this? 4 times A. What is 4 times A? 4 times A, 4 times 14, that is 28. 56, I'll write it here. 4A plus 2B, this is our second equation, remember? 4A plus 2B, that is 100. So 4 times, what is A? 14 plus 2B, 2 times 22 equals 100. Excuse my writing. Oh, I'm a terrible writer. I mean, look at how I write. Okay, 4 times 14, that is 56, plus 2 times 22 is 44, that is equal to 100. Okay, so there are 56 legs for the dogs, right? And 22 legs for the chickens. And how many dogs? There are 14 dogs and 22 chickens. If you have any questions, just send me a message. Bye-bye.